Welcome to Regrob. To the another episode of different aspect of Kolkata. As earlier, we have saw that there have been various videos about different parts, different foods of Kolkata. Now, coming too deep into that, now I will explain the topic outlandish places in Kolkata. It basically means the exotic places that you would ever visit in Kolkata. So coming to the first exotic place, actually Kolkata can be divided into four segments: north, south, central and east Kolkata. Coming to the north, north is the oldest part of the city. Then it comes to central. Central is the central business unit or central district of Kolkata. Business district of Kolkata. If you come to the towards south, the south is developed after the independence of India. So it is basically a old. It is basically a city with modernized but quite of old mixture. And coming to the last part, the east part, which comprises of modern urbanization like new town, DLF. So it is the it is a newly developed Kolkata, a newly developed area which consists of IT business hubs, business centers, etc. So coming to the north Kolkata, the exotic places, if you ever been visited, if you have been planning to visit Kolkata, or if you have a mindset of investing in Kolkata, then these are the some few exotic places of Kolkata where you could invest or visit. First is Marble Palace. Actually, Marble Palace is a place, is a palatial 19th century in North Calcutta. The house was built in 1835 by Raja Rajendra Malik, a wealthy merchant, Bengali merchant, with a passion of collecting work of arts. So Marble Palace houses many Western sculptures, pieces of Victorian furniture, painting, etc. of European and Indian artists and other art artifacts, etc. So if you come down, now we will looking into Raja Ram Mohan Roy Museum. This museum is a three-storied structure illustrative of the colonial style architecture of the 19th century. The city is said to be have been the residence of the family of Raja Ram Mohan Roy. This building is also known as the Shimla House because the area of that particular region was earlier known as Shimla, also called Shimla, S-I-M-L-A, Shimla. It has also a library attached to it and has been opened for the users since 27th September 2013. If you come down now, we will visit Vidyasagar Smriti Mandir, which is located on Vidyasagar Street and is one of the three campuses of Vidyasagar College of Women. This heritage building, which earlier served as a residence of Pandit Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar, was handed over to the Vidyasagar College of Women by the government of West Bengal. The museum has a glimpse of the living style and the contemporary works of Vidyasagar, so it is a definitive place to visit. Now, coming to the central Kolkata. If you look down, this is Raj Bhavan. As you all know, Raj Bhavan is an official governor, sorry, residential governor of West Bengal, located in the capital city of Kolkata, built in 1803, known as the government house, before the independence of India. So, Raj Bhavan was considered one, covers an area of 84,000 square feet and it is surrounded by a compound covering area of 27 acres. So it is a posh area. So coming down to the Calcutta High Court, it is one of the oldest high court in India. It has jurisdiction over the state of West Bengal and over Union Territory of Andaman and Nicobar as well. So Definitely, it is and one of the prime location in central Kolkata. If you come down now, it is GPO or rather known as General Post Office. General Post Office, Kolkata is a old and it is central. Sorry, is a central post of city Kolkata and chief post of West Bengal. The site of GPO is located was actually the site of first fortium. Yes, exactly, the first fort. This site was actually located where it is located now. It was the first site of the first fortium. If we come down now to South Kolkata, these are the places that you can visit. As you can see, it is a museum. It is rather it is to be called Sima Art Gallery. It is situated in Ashutosh Chowdhury Avenue, close to Baliganj Post Office. It is opened in Calcutta in 1993 under the support of a leading Indian media group, ABP LTD Limited, designed under the renowned art galleries, art museum in London and New York. If you visit another place, that is Ramakrishna Mission of Institute of Culture. As you all, Ramakrishna Mission was conceived in 1936 as one of the permanent memorials of Sri Ramakrishna on the occasion of his first birth centenary. The entire building complex was deemed a heritage building by Kolkata Municipal Corporation in 2007. So these are the places of Kolkata which are of high value or definitely a place to visit. Now comes the National Library. National Library is the country's largest library and the library of public records. The library is situated on a 30-acre, 30-acre or 30-acre or 12-hectare Belvedere Estate. It is the largest in India with a collection in excess of 2.2 million books. Yes, 2.2 million books. One of the facts. Now coming to the last part, it is known as the East Kolkata. As we all know, East Kolkata is the modern Kolkata, modern urbanization, modern hub. So, first place to visit is a recreational water park, Aquatica. Aquatica is a 7,05,000 square feet water theme park in Kolkata. Situated started in 1999, it is one of the largest water amusement park in Kolkata as well as Eastern India. Definitely a place to visit. After that, it is Eco Park, as we all know, the famous Eco Park. You can see the night view of Eco Park. It looks beautiful. Eco Park is an urban park in Rajarhat, Kolkata, and the biggest park so far. On 480 acres plot, and is surrounded by 104 water body with an island in the middle. According to the fact, it is one of the biggest in India so far. So definitely a place to visit with your family if you have if you have something to visit, like recreational, want to do something recreational activities, definitely a place to visit. After that, as you all know, Mother Wax Museum. This museum is located in New Town, established in November 2014. It contains statues of wax statues of more than 19 personalities, starting from SRK till Amitabh Bachchan, etc. The museum has been named after Mother Teresa. It is one of the finest museums you will find and definitely a place to visit. So, if you are further looking to invest in Kolkata and if you are thinking to have a quite exotic place to live in, so Kolkata is definitely a place to invest as well as to relish. So, if you are a lover of history or if you are a lover of heritage sites, it is definitely a place to visit at least once. And believe me, you will not get out of it. You will stay here forever. Thank you. We will come with another video.